Hello. Hello to all my replay viewers. Thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. This is your Lunch Bites installment. I have been a little bit absent this week because, hi, thanks for joining. I have been so sick this week, so I've been a little absent from my daily news show. But you guys, I'm back. I'm actually traveling right now. I'm on the road. So you guys are going to get an on the road edition. Hey, Drew, how are you? Thanks so much for following and for watching. I've got 7 headlines for you guys today, and I call it Lunch Bites. So that means wherever you are with your work coworkers at lunch, around the water cooler, wherever you are, you'll have the perfect conversation fodder, because this is like some cool and interesting weird stuff. So y'all definitely want to stay tuned. I try not to keep you long, so let's go ahead and dig in. We're going to start here at home with some news and that we've been following on Lunch Bites with North Carolina's governor, and that he's trying to soften the discriminatory provisions in the state's anti-LGBTQ law. Okay, so the Washington Post reported that the North Carolina governor, Pat McCrory, has responded to all that backlash that we've been hearing about the legislation that's eliminated protections for LGBTQ individuals, and has issued an executive order to soften some of those discriminatory provisions included in the new law. Now, it's interesting because one thing he did is he reinstated employment protection so that they cannot be fired based on their sexual orientation. But what he did not address is probably more interesting. So what he did not address is the bathroom provisions, meaning they're required to use the restroom that corresponds with the sex that is on their birth certificate. I'm kind of wondering if any of these changes are going to have to do, going to make any changes to PayPal. I know PayPal has wanted to do some things going on. No, I am not driving right now. I am just, I'm a passenger, so no worries. But anyway, yeah, I'm wondering if PayPal is going to reconsider, or they're going to reconsider their partnership, almost partnership. I don't know. We'll see. Something I definitely kind of wondered when I read it. Moving on. Thank you for the hearts, guys. If you're not following me, please do. I do this almost every day, and I give you lots of stuff just to be able to talk about in your daily lives. If you'll swipe left, you can share this on your iOS, and if you swipe down, you can share it on your Droid, and I would love you for that. Let's move on to headline number 2, you guys. It's a little nami nami headline we have here, and it's all about Wegmans. Now, if you don't know what it is, I'm going to tell you, because I had no idea. Wegmans is officially now America's favorite grocery store, apparently. It's even beat out Trader Joe's, okay? So apparently, it's Trader Joe's is ranked as the best supermarket in America, usually. For 4 years straight, it took home the prize, and that was by a company called Market Force. Does a annual customer survey, and so that's how they know. Well, this year is interesting because Wegmans won, and if you're scratching your head thinking, I didn't even know that was a grocery store, I'm with you on that, but it's probably because you don't live in the Northeast, which is the only place where the chain operates. And so it's interesting because the survey mostly was based on loyalty, which included a bunch of components. But basically, when it comes down to it, Wegmans got a 70% rating in their loyalty from customers. That's huge, guys. 76% rating. Publix, the very popular where shopping is a pleasure grocery store, only got 75, which is still good, but still less than Wegmans. And then we have Trader Joe's at 73. Are they expanding? I have yet to hear news that they're expanding, but I definitely think that they should consider it if they're getting such high loyalty rating. However, maybe it's because they are in such a small area that they are getting such a high loyalty rating. Perhaps if they were to expand, it would go lower. You'd love to get them in the Midwest, you say, Drew. Yeah, I'd love to get them. I'd love to get a Trader Joe's actually near where I am, because we don't have one of those either. So, but anyway, so we're gonna go ahead and move on to our next headline. It's a little bit about politics, you guys. Thank you for the hearts. I love it. All right, so Bernie Sanders and Hillary Clinton faced off in the final debate before next week's New York Democratic primary. So if you didn't know, next week it's going to be very interesting. If you guys want my Instagram, it's the same as on here, Chelsea Roadman. Same on everything. But yeah, so that Democratic Party's primary next week in New York, gonna be a big one, guys. Sanders, who was born in Brooklyn, or as they would say, Brooklyn. I don't know, maybe you guys can do that better than I can, but I have a lot of fun trying it. So he was born in Brooklyn, and Clinton, who served two terms as senator, they both claimed that state as their home turf. So, but within the first few minutes of this debate, both candidates were attacking each other's judgment on a record number of issues, including financial reform, gun control, and foreign policy. Guys, it's politics. You know how this stuff goes. So it's going to be interesting what happens next week. What happens with our primary there up in New York. So moving on to story number four, we've got some interesting news about, you guessed it, TikTok. It's my favorite. And you guys know it's my favorite. I love it. And so this one's pretty interesting. It's about Instagram, which is apropos since you guys were just asking me if I have an Instagram. I do, and my handle is at Chelsea Roadman, just like it is on here. And it's like it is on every social media pretty much known to man, except my Facebook page, which is / Chelsea Roadman PR, because I'm in PR branding. So other than that, you know, Google search my name, you'll find everything. But story number four is TikTok. So Instagram's explore section now includes videos that you might like, not just the photos. So today, so guys, this is as of today, the 15th of April, the app's explore section is going to introduce video channels. And according to Instagram, the feature helps connect you with videos that you'll love the same way that explore helps show you photos that reflect what you're interested in. So I think that's going to be pretty cool. That's another way you can see one of the platforms trying to keep up with this video platform explosion, and how we're trying to keep up with that. So it's interesting to see that. I'm excited for it. Story number five, we're gonna go a little celebrity talk here, you guys. Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt star Ellie Kemper has confirmed that she is pregnant with her first child. The actress shared the news during last night's Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, and she said, quote, "I have big news," as she pointed to her stomach, and she said that she is pregnant. Her husband is Michael Komen, and they have been married since 2012, and again, this is her first child, so best wishes to her for sure. All right, so moving on to story number six, we have a little more celebrity news going on. Miley Cyrus, who's always a controversial one up here in the news, Miley Cyrus and artist Marilyn Minter collaborated on a glamorous photo shoot to benefit Planned Parenthood. Minter photographed Cyrus in an exclusive session, and resulting prints will be sold in a limited edition on Artsy with 100% of the income. So not just partial, but 100% of the income will be sent to... Hey, moi! I just had to stop for a moment so that I could follow you because I didn't know you were on here. Hello. Okay, anyway, yeah, 100% of those proceeds, guys, are going to Planned Parenthood. So it's interesting that it's 100% and not just partial. Marc Jacobs will also sell t-shirts featuring additional images from the session through his site and in Marc Jacobs boutiques. So, very interesting. I'm gonna leave my... Oh, I see lots of you are joining. Hey guys, thanks for joining. We are about to hit our last headline on today's News Bites, or Lunch Bites, excuse me. So you guys are welcome to watch the replay. And I love it when you comment and tell me what you think, what your opinions are about these stories. So our last story, you guys, is going to be a little bit celebrity and a little bit sales. And this is not a drill. So be excited. A Rihanna makeup line is officially coming in 2017. Guys, it's been confirmed. A lot of you will be very excited to hear this. Some of you won't care at all, but That's the news. That's what it is. WWD has confirmed that a Rihanna makeup line is officially coming. The singer has inked a deal with LVMH, which is the company that is behind Kat Von D and Marc Jacobs Beauty, to release a product line called Fenty Beauty by Rihanna. That's the same name that Rihanna all but officially confirmed to Refinery 29 in an interview. So it looks like we've got some pretty interesting headlines today, covering a little bit of law. No, I'm not driving. Covering a little bit of politics and some celebrity headlines, as well as a little tech talk, because you know I love it. Guys, I'm not driving. All right, great lunch bites. Thanks so much, Drew, and thanks for joining. If you guys aren't following me, be sure that you swipe right on your iPhones and swipe down on your Droids to make sure that you're following me. Safety first. I am not, see, I'm the passenger, you guys. But anyway, please be sure you're following me, and I will have more lunch bites for you. Let's see, today is Friday, so they should be coming up on Monday. You guys have a great weekend, and I will check in with you later. Bye!